Oh, for the love of chimney-chimney-chimney-choo. What the hell am I reviewing this time? Could it be one of the things I showed you on the shelf? No, of course not. It's got to be this.
What is it?
It's a Zone 60. The 32-bit interactive wireless gaming system. With such happy people on the front of the case. It comes with a couple of Wii controllers. It's not a Wii. It just kind of looks like a Wii. But it's not. It does have motion control. But it's not. It's terrible. It really is terrible. It comes with 60 built-in games. 3 sports accessories. You know, if you ever wanted a bat. No. Just no. What the hell? So what the hell's in this box? I actually don't have a clue what's in this box. It arrived today. So, let's go nuts. Yeah, what do we have? The first thing we see is this, the Zone 60 user manual. And that's what I'm going to do with it. Right, let's have a look at these flimsy bloody things. This is the tennis racket, I assume. Let's have a look at these controllers. You know? Those buttons actually feel alright. Very similar to the other controller for the Zone 40, which I've yet to review because, what the hell. Let's do this. Stick this on the end, and suddenly it's a tennis racket. No. Never again. It comes with a bat and a... Oh, look! A ping pong ball. A ping pong bat, whatever they're called. Cheap plastic, just what I've always wanted. So yes, it comes with 2 controllers, both with those ridiculous wee bloody things you wrap around your wrist for people who are completely incapable of holding a controller in their hand. Right, that's the controllers. What else does it come with? An AC adapter, UK, because I'm in the UK, of course. What's next? What else we got? What's this thing? The bat. Yeah. I'll get a bat to this thing if it doesn't work. Oh, of course. Video. But this time, it comes with just a mono cable. What the hell is that? 2.5mm? Oh, for the love of... Yep. Basically, I'm going to have to get an audio splitter to make this kind of close to stereo, but... whatever. 2.5mm. Ugh, ridiculous. On the back, it's got the DC input for the plug and the AV out, of course. Made of cheap plastic. Zone 60 on the side. 2 buttons on the top. And that. Hilariously enough, you can see inside. I put my eyes exactly across that. And let's see. I can see the motherboard in there. I don't know if you can see it, but the motherboard is about that big. That big, and it goes to about here. It's like there. It's about that big. It's really tiny, and the whole thing is empty. Besides that. Way to go, guys. Thanks for actually showing me what the hell's in this thing, because I'll be damned if I know otherwise. Well, actually, I've got the DC input, so I don't really care about the batteries, but I hate screws on the bloody covers. I hate battery covers with screws. Stop that. Right, let's find out what the hell's on this thing.
Zone 60, interactive gaming system. Oh, hold the controller vertically. Fine, I will do so. Oh, that tune. At least it's got a better... user interface than the Zone 40, that's for certain. So, these are the controls. Unfortunately, boxing requires 2 controllers, but... These motions control games, they're not what you think. Let me just show you tennis, okay? Okay, so, let's launch that. Okay. So basically, all you have to do is just swing. You don't have to swing in any specific area. Just literally just swing. That's it. You can also press buttons if you really can't be bothered swinging your arm or can't. Really, I'm not doing anything. I'm not influencing anything. And I'm winning. I'm winning just by just going up and down in front of the console. That's pretty much all these motion. Motion, yeah, I even did the finger marks. You can influence the way the ball actually goes. Like, say, if I hold the left... if I hold left and swing, it should go to the left, in theory. See? Left. I'm holding left. It's continuously going left. It's staying left. Okay? So now I'm going to hold right. And suddenly the ball's going right all the time. That's all you have to do in this game. Just go up and down with your controller and push left or right on your controller. And I'm winning. I'm winning literally not even trying. The later levels are pretty much impossible. So, let's get the heck out of here. How do you... Ah! Oh, no you don't. Nice try. Get me out of here. No. Okay. The same goes for pretty much all of these games. They are influenced by your inputs in the buttons, and literally all it senses is... Wow, I didn't even press anything. I just moved the controller up. I guess that means get it. So, in other words, basically, it's just detecting whether the infrared has been connected and disconnected or not. That's all I'm assuming the hardware is actually doing. Did it lose connection from us for a second? Oh, that must mean he swung it. He totally swung it. Which is alright for kids. Like, I can understand that all these games are pretty fun for kids. So let's try bowling. I've not actually tried bowling yet, so... Let's literally kill ourselves. Right. Oop. What do I do? I have no idea what I'm doing. I did nothing. I did nothing and I got a strike. All I pressed was the top button of the controller. I'm not sure what the hell happened. Okay. I'm swinging the motion controller, doing a whole lot of nothing. All I did was press up, and suddenly it's going up and down. If I press X, it will go. If I get it anywhere outside of there, it won't swing. I don't know how I'm influencing this, so I'm going to have to read the user manual, which I threw. But the motion games are pretty terrible. Hey, let me leave the game. I pressed quit. Don't even try that with me. Get me out of here. Get out of here. So yeah, these motion games, not great. They're not great on the Zone 40 either. However, the reason why I really like these is the mini games. They're called mini games in this, but they're just called arcade games in the Zone 40, I believe. But this has 48 very different games, and I think they're all original. I'm fairly certain they're original. Well, as original as you can get with a fake Wii. Some of them are actually pretty darn fun. I was having a blast with a couple of them. How do I control this? Oh, yes, you hold it horizontal. Derp, derp, de derp. Yes, here we go, I've got it now. Ball battle. Let's just go for that. Let's just go through as many games as possible and let's see what we can do. I'm not sure what you have to do in this game, but from what I gathered is you connect the colours and you connect five and you suddenly do good. I don't know whether they have to be next to each other or in a line, so let's try that, shall we? Give me the blue. Whoop. Quickly grab that one and put it next to it, maybe. No, it has to be in a line. Ah, there we go. And that's pretty much all you have to do. It gets harder because balls keep appearing, and it gets pretty annoying pretty fast. But they are simple 32-bit games. The picture quality is not that bad for a plug-and-play device. In fact, I'm quite satisfied with the graphical fidelity of a very cheap plug-and-play for people that can't quite afford a Wii, even though Wiis are their lowest ever.
right now. But even if you can't afford it, this alternative, hey, I can dig it. I can dig it. It's not bad. Kids will enjoy this. They will. Not the motion games. Teach them to hate motion games and you will have a happy child. I mean, sad. Yes, totally. Speaking of the Wii, I actually played on the Wii today for the first time in a while. I played Super Monkey Ball Banana Blitz with my girlfriend and we had a whale of a time. I've not had that much fun on a motion control game in a while, so that's just a little trivia out there for you. But then again, I won't be uploading this video till for a while after the fact because I've got to edit this and do everything. But anyway, Big Burger. I don't get this Big Burger game. I honestly don't get it. I'm not doing the racing one, the first game, because it's weird. Not sure what the heck I'm meant to do. I know I'm meant to walk over this, but that is all I know. Oh, I'm meant to make a burger, I think. So if I go from the top, it pushes everything down. So if let's try making a burger. Let's go. I'm gonna make a burger. Go, get off me. Burger. Oh, and you can kill things. Ah, that's nice. Making a burger. Let me make a burger. Now this is a simplistic game and suddenly I like it. I just made a burger. I literally just made a burger. Sweet. I do approve of this game. Mostly because of my love for burger. Just killed the monsters. Sweet. So you have to also strategically run over them and kill the creatures before they kill you. Oh snap, running away. Oh snap, you can't run over the edge. I thought you actually could. It seems that's not a thing in this game. Let's make another burger. I've made a burger. Oh. I know where to go. Go. What's the ice cream? It's not moved. It might kill us. I don't know. Let's find out. It's not a... It didn't kill us. Go. It kind of reminds me of Pac-Man trying to avoid the ghosts. But you can actually strategically kill these guys. That is pretty awesome. Oh. Hi, you can only get over. Oh, don't be smart. Nobody likes a smart cookie. Oh, snap. We got problems. They're actually coming after me. Okay, come on. Yes. Go, Dan. Oh, my God. Well, I'm actually having fun. What is that? I'm having fun with a plug and play game? Hilarious. I win! Yes! I actually won. That is impressive. Let's not do stage two, because we need to get through as many games as possible. I might not be able to get through all the games on this plug and play. As said, there is 60 games on here. I've cut out quite a few of them, which is the motion, because they're terrible. They are. Braveheart. Didn't like Braveheart. Ball Blaster. I think I liked that one. Let's try that. Ah, yes, I did like that. This one. You have to shoot balls into other balls and clear the thing as it goes along. That's cool, right? Kind of reminds me of a bubble blast on Sky Interactive. I don't know if they actually still have it. No, Beehive Bedlam. That's what it was called. For those of you who have Sky in the UK, or at least have had it a while, you probably have heard of it and or played it. It was a free game on Sky Interactive. I have no idea if it's still there. I might check that after this. And if it is still there, I will have a good play on it. Because it was so fun. It kept me entertained for hours. On Sky. Are you insane? The thing's for TV. Oh, throw the green into that. There we go. Yeah, the objective is to keep those away from the whole thing that they're heading towards. So basically spit out as much as you possibly can. The sound effects are simple. There's a lot packed onto this little plug and play. I am genuinely surprised at how much is packed onto this. It's impressive. I like it. I do like the Zone 60. Zone 40 is also pretty darn fun. Hilariously enough, there's the Zone 40 has 40 games on and this has 60. None of the games on this console are on the Zone 40. They are both completely separate consoles with separate game lists, which is phenomenal if you want both devices, because you'll have an excuse to get both, because I am completely terrible at this game. Because, you know, That's how it works. Oh, hit that green. There we go. Hit it back. Sometimes it'll get hit back, sometimes it won't. Let's get rid of that one. That'll make a chain reaction for that one. Throw the yellow there. Boop. Throw the green there. Throw the yellow there. Throw the red there. So, yeah, this is a fun little game. They stop coming after a while, and they will kick their own backside, it seems. I assume. I have no idea. I can't actually remember. Oh, no, don't want to fire the green there. I actually pressed the button, but it didn't fire. I'm not going to question why. Oh, we got a problem right here. Oh, snap. Green, red, yellow. Kind of reminds me. Yeah, it does remind me of, like, Bubble Poppers and Beehive Bedlam, for sure, this game. Except with a difference. Not a twist, but more of a difference. Ah, shove the green thing there. Red, green, green, yellow. Oh! Did I win? I won, I think. I don't know, I have no idea. Either that or I failed. Probably failed. But either way, that was whatever that game was called. Ball Blaster. Caddy. What the hell was Caddy? Oh, this game... Oh, I like playing this game. Okay, you have to match up these. You're hitting the balls, and you have to match them up at the bottom. It starts off relatively simple like this, but then gets pretty difficult halfway through. Okay, now let's do all the greens. Yeah, basically, whatever you put at the bottom, if it doesn't match, it goes underneath on the bottom row. So say... I'll show you now. Right. Say I put that purple there, and I was like, okay, and accidentally put the blue one there. It'll pile up down here. So now I've gone and screwed myself over. Oh, snap. Eh. Right, here we go. So yeah, you just have to think about how to literally mix all these up. I don't know if we're actually scoring or how many misses were allowed. I have no idea. Honestly, have no idea. I just found this game quite entertaining. A fun little game for kids. Isn't that what this console's for? So, I'm actually quite behind this console. It's pretty good. Right, let's put the bowling ball there. Go. 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 As you can tell, I'm pretty good at this game. Yay. 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 And then it gets harder. You have to match four balls instead of three, and so on and so forth. It gets harder and harder and harder, and it becomes a fun little game that I approve. Gold Digger. This is... it reminds me of, you know the little claw arcade game? That's really fun. Well, the objective of this is to press the button when the claw is pointing at one of the coins and grab it, and the goal is to grab as much as you can within 1 minute. Oh, snap, this is... not going to succeed. There's no way I'm going to do this. Oh, I managed to grab that. But yeah, that's the objective of this game. It's, you know, it's literally nothing special. It's a fun little title. Will keep you entertained for a while, especially if you're trying to beat the high score. So, yeah, I'm not going to try beating the high score now. Probably won't anyway. Okay, Cooking Chaos. This is an entertaining little game. I like the art style of it, and I like the idea that these little mice, cat, rat things are baking a cake off the things that are falling off something that birds are dropping. I just find that quite adorable. Actually, it reminds me of a couple of Disney movies from back in the day. Especially the design of the fat mouse, which kind of reminds me of the fat one from... Is it Cinderella? I can't remember. I've not watched old Disney movies in many years. I should probably have a marathon of watching those things just for memory's sake. But the objective of this is to collect all the cherries for the top of this cake. I don't know why you'd want, like, 41 cherries on this cake, but obviously they want them. You're supposed to collect as many as possible, and you will. Don't collect the purple things. It's bad, apparently. That's all I know. So long as you collect the things it wants you to collect, which is shown in the top right, you should be good to go. I'll show you what happens when you get that. You go, oh, no, I got hit. But anyway, I succeeded anyway. Congratulations, 38 out of 41. Okay. I think you have to get a certain amount within the time limit. Now it's kind of... I think they're cornflakes. I have no idea what the hell they are. Or nuts. I don't know. I'm not pretending to know. Whoop, ready, go. Oh, damn, missed. Go. Go. Balls! But anyway, that was that game. Another fun little title on this 32-bit plug and play. I was a bit negative in the unboxing, but that's because the Zone 40 left a bitter taste in my mouth. But this one is a big improvement. No! I tested that one out before, and no. No. You have to throw coconuts in a barrel, and no. Just no. It's practically impossible. I fail. Now this! I had fun with this. I probably played this for a good 20 minutes before hitting the record button. And I stopped there. I didn't play any other plug-and-play game. Because I'm just having fun with this one. Kind of wish something like this was on the Star Wars plug-and-play. I'm sure many of you would agree that a game like this on the Star Wars plug-and-play, perhaps like when you're destroying the Death Star, I know it's not part of Revenge of the Sith, but something like this would have been really fun on there. You know, running through the Death Star, shooting as many TIE Fighters as you possibly could. TIE Fighters, was that the one? I don't know, I've not watched the original trilogy in a long time. I can't remember a lot of things about it, but to be honest. Which is, I'm quite ashamed of, but whatever. I'm more of a Star Trek guy anyway. No offense! I do like Star Wars. I like them all. I will not say which one I think's better because, quite frankly put, I think Babylon 5 is probably the best sci-fi that ever came out ever. But you know what? I'm part of a niche market. A lot of people don't like Babylon 5, so whatever. But yeah, this game is really fun. It's simple. You're just flying around, dodging all these yellow bullet things, shooting, and trying to avoid being rammed into. Because yes, they will ram into you, the little ship things. Whatever they are, I don't know what they are. It's just a pixelated mess from what I can see. With some skull thing on it, it looks like we killed it. Whenever we beat a boss, they seem to fly away, which is replaced by another one, which has a different firing style, which keeps you interested, doesn't make you bored of the game pretty fast. So, I do approve of that. So let's go for another game before I... Okay, I got killed. Just as I quit. Hilarious. What else is there? Dragon. What's this dragon game? Dragon. Oh, yes. Yeah, you see that? You can jump around and the objective is to keep going up. And you can... Your only ability is jump and fire that thing. And you can collect stuff for more score, I think. Let's have a look. Yeah. Okay. The awesome thing about your attack that kills the little creatures that will kill you is that you can actually jump on them and use it as a platform, which I ultimately failed in showing you. Damn it. Alright, let's just jump up quickly. Yeah. Kill the bat. I want to kill the bat. Oh, snap. Don't want to do that. I actually completed this level. Believe it or not. First time. Nope. I'm supposed to jump on it straight away. Yeah, you're not allowed to hit the bottom of the map. Right, go, yes, kill, yes. Oh, I don't know if I can get up there, but just in case I can't, yeah, there we go, kill, yeah, if an enemy gets hit with it straight away, so as you can see, you can't get up here, and you're like, the first time I played this, I was like, how the hell do you get up there, what the hell do I do, I didn't realize you could actually jump on the dragon thing. Which I think that's an awesome thing. I've not seen that in the game before. And I really doubt this is an innovative console. So I'm not even going to go there and say that this is the first game that's done that. Which I'm going to assume hasn't. But I've not actually seen that in a game before. So I'm pleasantly surprised by it. So yes, I've just beat the level. I win. Yay. And there's another level it goes through and it carries on all the way like that. But I actually do like that game. That game was definitely impressive. Egg collector. No idea what this is. Oh, yes, I do. Basically, left, right, boop, catch the eggs. Simple game, I'm sure you guys can wrap your head around the concept of this game. Literally, boop, boop. The funny thing is, all I have to do is just press right once. You can tell this was designed for children, because if I press left once, just once, it'll go... What? What? I don't actually know what the hell just happened there. I don't know how that happened. No idea. Anyway, like, if I just press it once, it'll go over there, see? So, you've got three columns to go in to catch the eggs. Press left once, I'm in the middle. Press left again, I'm in the left. And if I press right once, I'll go in the middle. So it's a simplistic game. It's not overly difficult. I know I dropped an egg, but something happened that I wasn't... I've not seen that before. I don't understand why that's a thing. I know I dropped an egg. I'm sorry. Please don't kill me. But anyway, yep. Hold the controller horizontally in both hands. Stop trying to be the way. Right, find the way. No. What is this game? I honestly don't know what this game is. What the... All I know is I'm using moves. What the heck is this game? What? Oh! I know what I'm doing. Kind of. Let's put you over there. Put you over there. Yep. And then we put the red one there. And then we put the... yellow one there. And, oh! We got a problem. We can't get Mr. Green there, can we? Oh, how do I do that? 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 How do I... I don't know how to do it. Yeah, there we go, did it. Brain got around. So that's a simplistic game. I just learned it now, literally. It seems I was making it more difficult than it should have been. Well, we all know that's not gonna work. We need to get the yellow... Oh, burp. No, don't. Come back. There we go. One. I made that more difficult in my head. But anyway, that's find the way. You have to find the way into the holes. That's simplistic enough. I don't know how long this review is going to go on. I might cut it down. I might not. I don't really know. I'm just going to go through as many games as I possibly can. Finger dancing? What the... What? What? What's that? I don't know what that is. I know I didn't get it, because I don't actually know what the hell that was. What? You have to press the directional keys for this. Oh, that's kind of cool. I don't know if it's a rhythm game or a race against time. What's that? I don't know what that button is. I think I pressed the right button then. I literally guessed the buttons on the other keys. Oops, wrong button. Kind of reminds you of rhythm games of old. Oops. Made it. I won. Simple. Kind of reminds me of a dancing stage without the dancing or anything else. That's a fun little game. I could play that again. Firefighter. Why have they made this game look more cooler than what it probably is? Push A button. Okay. Stage one. What do I do? Oh, that's adorable. What do I do now? What the heck? Right, get him. Awesome. Oh, I see what happened. It's kind of like, what's it called? The one where you have to hit the ball into the different shapes. Oh! I'm sorry, sir. I'm so sorry. I hope I'm not being timed for this. And I hope nobody's recording. Wait a minute. I'm recording. No. Oh, snap. I'm not doing very well at this, am I? Oh. It's okay. I'm here to help you. Woohoo. What did I do? There you go. Save that person. Oh, save that person. What's that? Mine now. Oop, nope, missed. No. Ooh, free water. Wait. What the? Did I just make it? Seriously? Firemen cannot make things rain. I just wanted to put... What? Guest bonus?
What?
Did I win? I'm so sorry for the people that died. But that's Firefighter. That's actually a pretty fun game. I like that. I like that game. There's very few games on this console that I actually don't like. Of course, I'm not going to like all of them. There's 60 games. It's impossible to like them all. But, new game, the password, quit. Okay. What am I meant to do? I don't actually know what the objective is. Oh, that's the objective. Right, gotcha. Yay, I beat it just by rotating. I am the best rotating mushroom in the world. Oh, crimey. Yay! Yeah! That's actually a pretty fun game. But no more. No more, please. No more. No more. I refuse. My brain was starting to hurt. That was a fun game. What are we at to now? 17? Ugh, out of like 48. So, yeah, I probably won't grab them all. What the heck's this? Oh my god! Yay! Wait. Oh! Oh, this is like the racing games of old. Yay! With actually 32-bit graphics, which I've never seen before. I've not actually seen this done in 32-bit graphics, so... That's... new, I guess. Hey, I'm not racing against anyone else. Why? I assume I'd play against the second player if they joined. I'm not gonna try it. Okay. I'm winning. Last lap, 976. I did better that time. Oh yeah. This is realistic racing, folks. I've not seen a racing simulator quite as good as this one. He lied. Yay, I won. That was that. I don't even want to name it. I can't remember the name. There's so many names to these games that I'm not going to remember the names of any of them. Go-karts. Okay. Hay bales! Now let's go to 20 and I'll leave the rest for you guys. I think that'll be better. I don't want this to drag on too long. What's this? Ow. Okay. What the heck? What do I do? I'm pressing buttons and the only thing I can do is jump and move left and right. I don't genuinely know what the hell's going on. Oh, snap. Freedom! 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 I'm okay. Freedom! Freedom! Let me out! Let me out! Oh, hold on. What the heck? Yes. Okay. Wait, is this like Tetris? Let's find out. It is like Tetris, kind of, in a way. I am flabbergasted, yet also amused. Nope, before I get killed. Oh, well, this is fun. Okay, I approve of this game. I had no idea what I was doing. Oh, almost killed myself. Thank you for helping, person who's chucking things over there. Are they gravity enabled? Please be gravity enabled. Whoa. Did I die? No. I can't grab that. Oh, I have to stack them up to get up there. Ow, killed myself. Good enough. You mind? I'm busy. I'm busy stacking these up. Trying to make a difference. Don't kill me. No, no. Right. No. No! Don't be... I'm trying so hard to get up there. No! Not me. Nope. Grab that one. Got it. Nope. Yeah. Simple. Think with blocks. Remind you of a game, anybody? Alright, so that's that game. I don't know if you can beat it. I don't care anymore. That's a fun little game once I figured it out. This review is getting pretty late in the day. Oh, God. What's this? I got a hammer and I can jump. Right, that's good enough for me. Come here, yes. Come. Just what I needed. Come here. How do I get down? No. No, you will not bring your friend back to the life. You will die. You will stay dead. Oh, my God. They can kill me? Awesome. Now I need something to kill. Wait, can they get back up? What? They can... What the... What did I just do? I don't know what I did, but I'm going up here. Right, come here. Come on. Yeah, let's do this. I win. Wait, did I just win? No, he's not dead, I guess. Do I have to hit him again? Beat him to death. Just beat him to death. Wait, or can I jump up more? I don't actually know how to win this game. How do you kill him? Die! Good enough. I think I've beat him to death. He's not dead, but whatever. I don't actually know how to kill this guy. Okay. What's the last game we're going to do? Hot drop. Okay. What? Oh my God, it reminds me of Furby. Not Fur, is it Furby? Furby's Dreamland. No, that's the one. That's sweet. And you have to avoid the things. Oh, wait, did I get bigger or is that just me? Whoop. Oh snap. Oh, I'm alive. What do I do? I don't get it. Ah, escape. Not sure what the objective is. Let's just keep going up until I win. Or do I have to capture all the bubblegum? Right, caught them all. Ah. Oh, my spaceship. You know, for the final game, that actually ended on a pretty high note. That's a fun little game. Wait, what are these bombs? Can I actually eat them? Let me eat them. No, I can't eat them. Ah, well. Anyway, this was the Zone 60. I'll leave the rest of the games for you guys to find out. It's a fun little console, and I'm going to give you my final thoughts on it right now. So, what are my final thoughts on the Zone 60? You know what? It's a fun little console that I managed to get for less than £10 only because no one else was bidding on it on eBay and the seller was willing to add postage onto it, you know, willing to post it out. He just wanted collection in person, but I was like, you know, I'll pay for the postage, man. I'm not bothered. I'm the buyer after all. I'll pay for the postage, you send it out to me, and I will be happy because I've been looking for this for a while. So, I can recommend it. It's got so many different games to... The Zone 40! They don't have the same games, they're two completely different consoles. So, if you can grab both of them, or a bunch of the Zone consoles, you're gonna have a whole bunch of fun. You really are. Now, the motion controls are pretty much the only downside to these Wii Ripoff clone console plug-and-play type games. That's the only downside to this. If they got rid of that and set their focuses on providing a 32-bit, you know, console with a bunch of fun little games on it, this could go far, and you know what, it has gone far. They've sold a lot of units. They've sold a lot of units. There's loads of videos about these things on YouTube and stuff, and you know what, I'm just gonna add my video onto the cesspool because I can. So yeah, if you can grab one of these on the cheap from your local charity store, pawn shop, I don't know, eBay, Craigslist, wherever you can grab it, you can get it cheap, get it.
Get it?
You got nothing to lose besides, oh, pennies that you would have spent anyway on bundles. Which is pretty much what I do anyway. So, I recommend the Zone 60. I recommend you get one. If I had to give it a rating, I would give it... You know, screw ratings. I recommend it. What more do you want? You want a goddamn number? I give it 87 out of 100. I take 13 off just because of the motion controls. There you go. Is that better? The fact remains that it comes with an AC adapter, which is necessary because I hate batteries. I mean, I was just while I was rendering the footage for the Zone 60, I actually went and reviewed the Zone 40 because I was like, I should have reviewed the Zone 40 first, but whatever, I digress. Let's move on to that. So, but yeah, the batteries went in the Zone 40, and I was having so many problems because two batteries were full, two batteries were kind of empty. So it worked for like a minute, and then it just completely glitched out, and I was like, have I broke the console? I broke the console. But I got it to work. So anyway, Zone 60. Love it or hate it, it's here to stay. It's a fun 32-bit console, and I recommend it wholeheartedly. So, you know what? If you like fun games like I do, I'm a kid at heart, guys. If a game's fun, I'll play on it. And I'll certainly be playing on this again. So, I'll see you guys next time, guys. Take care.